Good morning, welcome back to the structural geology. So let's start with causes and mechanism of fault. So faults are produced from several causes. So these are two types, tectonic causes and non-tectonic causes. In tectonic process, it involving forces operating within the crust of the earth. And in non-tectonic processes, it involving the gravity force. So first we will discuss about the tectonic process. In tectonic process, three forces are acting, that is horizontal tension, horizontal compression and vertical movements. First, horizontal tension. So in horizontal tension, rocks fail under tension along near vertical fracture or along shear fracture dipping over 60 degree. So this is the bedding rock strata. Due to horizontal tension or tensional forces, the fault, normal faulting is appeared. Or in this process, normal fault is produced. Then horizontal compression. In horizontal compression, rocks fail under compression along low angle fracture. And in this force or compression, reverse fault or thrust fault may be produced. And in this, angle is very low, and in horizontal tension or normal faulting process, angle is greater or greater than 60 degree. Then comes to the vertical movement. In vertical movements of faulting, there are stiff fault or forced gravens, like for block mountains are produced. In this movement, it is associated with folding, like arching or depressing the rock strata, developing tensional forces by which the rocks fail by rupture with differential movements. In this process, rift valley, forced graben or stiff faults are produced. Then comes to the non-tectonic process. So in this process, faults are produced due to rock deformation, landslides, etc. A successive of slightly curved parallel fractures with characteristic displacement occur in rock bodies under certain conditions due to landslide, slumping. So in the non-tectonic process, block mountain faults are produced, that is stiff fault is also produced. Then comes to the mechanism of fault. Faults are considered shear fractures. E. M. Anderson in 1950 has explained the mechanism of three types of faulting based on the relative magnitude and direction of principal stresses acting on rock masses. So E.M. Anderson gives some rules about their mechanism of faulting. The first rule is, your fault plane must pass through the principal axis of intermediate stress. So this is your greatest stress, this is your least stress, and this is your intermediate stress, and fault plane must pass through the intermediate stress axis. Then second rule is, your fault plane must exhibit angle of 30 degree with respect to principal axis of maximum stress. The fault plane makes an angle of 30 degree to the principal axis of maximum stress. third rule is your displacement should be perpendicular to the principal axis of intermediate axis. And this displacement is perpendicular to the intermediate axis of principal stress. And this is your intermediate axis of principal stress. And this is your fault plane. These two are perpendicular to each other. So, he described three types of fault, that is normal fault, reverse or thrust fault, and lateral faults. The first is your normal fault. When the greatest principal stress axis, that is PP, is vertical and intermediate stress axis, that is QQ, and least stress axis, that is RR, are horizontal, shearing or fracture takes place in rocks at very high angle of dips of the fault plane of, that is 70 degree to 80 degree, head is your 10 degree to 20 degree, with down slip, down dip dislocation, producing a normal fault. So how normal fault is produced? When the principal, greatest principal stress axis is vertical and rest other two principal axes are horizontal, and the angle of dip is 70 degree to 80 degree, then normal fault is produced. Next comes to the reverse fault. When reverse faults are produced, when least principal stress axis, that is R, is vertical, least principal stress axis R is vertical, and the greatest principal stress axis P and intermediate stress axis Q are horizontal, shearing or fracture takes place in rocks at very low angle of dip of the fault plane of usually 30 degree or less, head 60 degree or more. Head, dip and head are complement angle, and dip, suppose dip is your 20 degree, then head is your 70 degree, 90 degree minus dip is your head angle. So, in the reverse or thrust fault, least principal stress axis, that is R, is vertical, but in normal fault, greatest principal axis, that is P, is your vertical, rest two are horizontal. Always one principal stress axis is vertical and the other two are horizontal. Then comes to the lateral fault. In lateral fault, intermediate stress axis, that is Q, is vertical and the greatest stress axis P and least stress axis R are horizontal. Shearing or fracture takes place along the vertical planes about 30 degree or less to the greatest stress axis P, with horizontal dislocation of strata along one or both these fracture plane, producing lateral faults. Lateral faults is also known as tri-slip fault. So this is the mechanism of the fault, that is normal fault, reverse fault and lateral fault. In normal fault, the greatest principal stress axis is vertical and the angle of dip is 70 to 80 degree. In reverse fault, the least stress axis, that is R, is vertical and the angle of dip is less than 30 degree. And in lateral or strike slip fault, the intermediate stress axis, that is Q, is vertical and the angle of dip is also less than 30 degree. This is all about mechanism of faulting. Thank you.